time gardening, and one tends to bend over when one's gardening. And so it seems I've created a perfect platform for a certain cat to lie and sit on. You're such a silly puss cat. Oh, now you're using my arm as a bridge. If I lower my arm, oop, there you go, you jump off. Bold kitty.
So this is an example of a hellebore with its full leaves. And this is the time of year you prune them back. You can see here there's ferns and stuff. These are kind of evergreen ferns. They die back sometimes, but stay a lot of the time. I have a very purry assistant here, or at least one of my assistants is very purry. But if you come down in here, you can see there are the hellebore buds. This is one of my white hellebores, which I got dug up and split when my cousin died. I dug it up from her garden, and it's a beautiful, beautiful, pure white hellebore. And I have them in a few locations that I split up. One is here, and then there's two other locations where they are. I'm not gonna prune this one out just because, yet anyway, until the buds are more, just because I like the entranceway to have a bit of green. This is into the garden here. That's one of the entranceways. And it has this beautiful flaming red Cotoni aster. In normal years, this would have nearly been plucked clean by the birds, but it's such a mild winter, they're not all that hungry. Here you can see there's some baby foxgloves. They're gonna come up and they're gonna look really, really beautiful against that stone wall. So in amongst here, there's crocuses and snowdrops. Or maybe those are crocuses, I can't remember. Maybe they're snowdrops. Anyway, they're all gonna come up. But what I will dig up is the buttercup, the creeping buttercup, which will smother everything. So there's only a little bit of it there that I'll clear up. Are you assisting me? Are you trying to grab the clippers out of my hand? You're very bold. You can see I have very enthusiastic gardening assistants. Yes, I just don't want them digging holes where I don't want them digging holes. Bear is chewing bits of grass and bits of bark. You're being so helpful, Bear. So Pepper is inside next to the auger. He's been out helping, but I felt it was getting too chilly. Here you can see is some Jack in the Pulpit, or Lords and Ladies is coming up. That's that what that is there. And then over here, those are bluebells. Those are all bluebells coming up. And then that is some celandine coming up right there. So you can see there's lots of things in under this fig tree. This is a fig tree. These figs won't ripen. They produce figs continuously, and it's only during the months of July, August, and September that you can eat figs off of this fig tree. So that's one of the things that I'm doing today. As you can see, loads of assistance, with dogs picking up sticks, cats purring and jumping on my back as I bend over, plucking bits and pieces. Isn't that right, Bear? Yeah, Bear. The cat's found something. Bear thinks it's a mouse, or a vole, or a shrew. No, he doesn't have anything. Jumping up to get some water out of the bird bath. Isn't that right, kitty? You clever kitty. So under this espaliered apple tree that we've been told is one of the biggest in Ireland, freestanding espaliered apple tree, we have two different hellebores. There's this kind of hellebore, which it gets very large, but the blooms are at the end of its leaf stems. So you can see, ideally I should probably plant this somewhere where it's sunny and not so sheltered during the summer months with the canopy of leaves.
And we have a second one here. These are two different kinds. And they, my grandfather got them in their native country and brought them back in the 1930s, I think, or 20s, not sure. Here is the other kind of hellebore. You can see the ferns are lovely. Look at the ferns on the spaliered apple tree. But here you can see the bloom at the end of this leaf structure and stem. But this is the other kind of hellebore. So these are the leaves that I'll be pruning back. And if you go down in here, there's some baby hellebores. But if I take the leaves out, those dead apple leaves, you can see the buds. So I'm going to prune these leaves back so that the flowers can come up and bloom and look beautiful. These ones I leave alone. These I leave alone. And then here's another, a different one again. And again, I go down here and you lift up and you can see these are where the flowers are coming up underneath the buds, right there. So I'll prune these all back so that they can bloom and look gorgeous during the month of January and February. So that's what I'm doing today, with, of course, the help of Thyme. Thyme kitty! Yep, off he goes. I haven't picked up the fence that's around the wildflower garden since the storm blew it over. Just been doing all kinds of other things. Sometimes some jobs just get left and you watch them sitting there. But then I want the cheer up of seeing the blooms of the hellebore, which will be lovely in January. It's always lovely to have something coming up and looking forward to every season of the year. And January and February are the hellebores, bluebells, crocuses, and daffodils. January, February, and March. So there we go. As long as the dogs don't trample through, like some are wont to do, everything should be glorious in a little while.